While the world assumes that Newton's third law, which strikes the Métis in Manipur, would open their eyes, they continue to unleash relentless atrocities and heinous crimes against the vulnerable Kukizo minority in Jiribam district. When the radicalized Métis mob set the Imphal Valley ablaze, their G5, a conglomerate of five Métis militant groups, indulged in burning down at least five churches and eight residential houses in Jiribam district on the evening of November 16. This left the vulnerable Kukizo community in shock as places of worship and homes, symbols of their faith and refuge, were reduced to ashes. More alarmingly, the Métis militant groups have also abducted two innocent men from the Kukizo community, one of whom was found dead, dumped inside a culvert. His body showed signs of brutal torture, with his hands bound behind his back and his head severely smashed. This latest attack comes on the heels of the shocking rape and murder of Zo Sang Kim Mar, a tragedy that has stirred outrage across the region, further stoking the flames of fury already ignited by the recent massacre of 10 Kukizo volunteers. Vehemently condemning the incidents, the Kuki in P. Jiribam, Tamenglong and Noni, KIJTN, has called for immediate action to halt the destruction and ensure the safety of the Kukizo community in the region. According to KIJTN, the churches destroyed in the attack include the Independent Church of India, Evangelical Free Church of India, Booth Tucker School and Salvation Church, Presbyterian Church and Pastors' Quarters, and the Evangelical Assembly Church. In addition to the churches, residential homes were also targeted. The houses of Lalri Hekte, Zonun Moy T Hotel, John Daniel Tolor, Thangsang Lur, Calvary Moy, David Amo, Upa Lalholin, and Kaya Zoute were either set ablaze or vandalized in the coordinated assault. According to the KIJTN, the attack took place in Kali Nagar Marvang, Jiribam on the night of November 16, 2024, despite the heavy presence of state police and central security forces in the area, raising serious concerns about the effectiveness of the security measures. The KIJTN further emphasized that, despite the Supreme Court of India's orders to safeguard religious places and buildings from damage or destruction, these directives have proven ineffective as the relentless destruction of Kukizo properties continues without interruption. Strongly condemning the brutal killing, the Kuki in peace stated that Hao Joel Dongel, aged 27, a husband to a pregnant woman, and Thangzengul Dongel, aged 30, both from Pangmol village in Tamenglong and currently residing in a relief camp in Assam, were abducted from Jirighat by the Arambai Tengol and Métis militant groups. According to the Kuki Inpi, the brutally tortured body of Hao Joel was recovered from Aglapur village in Jiribam with his hands and mouth tied and his body allegedly thrown into a culvert. As of now, the whereabouts of Thangzengul remain unknown. The Kuki Inpi has called on the Kachar District Administration and police to remain vigilant, prevent further violence, and ensure the safety of displaced civilians seeking refuge in Assam. They also urge the central government to intervene urgently to de-escalate tensions and seek justice for the victims through a political solution.
Boot takar to school to office quarter way. My tower is here.
Yeah. Where are
you going? Where are you going? Where are you going?
Dar di.
ভালো করে ভালো করে।